Alright, so we got a little double YouTube vid today. This usually doesn't happen, but this is the first one you're seeing. As you know, it's Stanley Cup Day Bruins. Yeah, that's the next video. EJ Montgomery, I'm wearing the Kentucky shirt, coming back to Kentucky. This is a huge surprise to some. EJ was leaning, my guess to Kentucky the whole time. I personally thought for most of the process, because it started off with EJ Montgomery. Alright, EJ, he put his name in the draft, just like most people do, yada, 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 okay? Puts his name in. He's like, if I'm not going to be a first rounder, I'm coming back to Kentucky. All right, well, some time went by. If I'm a second rounder, okay, I'm going to go to the draft. All right, well, time went by. He didn't get an invite to the combine, and then he finally did after a while. But it went to where he goes, all right, if I can get a guaranteed two-year contract if I'm undrafted, I'm going to leave Kentucky. So I guess... Look, EJ averaged 3.5 points, something around that line his freshman year at Kentucky. And on Kentucky Sports Radio yesterday, they were saying, look, EJ's been working out with Tony Delk, who's a Kentucky great. And, you know, Tony was like, he thought EJ was going to go pro. He really did. But looks like EJ's coming back. EJ did say, though, like they were saying on KSR yesterday, why do Kentucky fans care if I come back? They all think I suck anyway. Which, yeah, look, that hurts. Because, like, I think EJ is going to have a huge second year. I think he's going to be looking like a PJ Washington. PJ's freshman year did not live up to the hype at all. His sophomore year, arguably Kentucky's best player. And possibly going to be Kentucky's highest draft pick. But that's what I could see. A huge step for EJ. If EJ can just get his confidence... EJ can be a very, very, very scary player. So I'm really happy Montgomery's returning. His high school is really close to mine, 30 minutes away. I saw him in high school play a couple times, and he's down-to-earth type of guy. I met him. We got to play a little basketball last summer together. He's just a cool guy to talk to, and he's just down-to-earth, one of the nicest people on the team last year. He's always got a smile on his face, but he's just a good player, and I'm glad for him. EJ, like this, I think this is going to be a big decision, like a great decision for EJ. I'm really proud that he made this decision, and I can only expect great things for EJ. I feel like going from an undrafted position, maybe even late second round, I feel like EJ Montgomery can work his way over the summer and over the course of the year to becoming a first round pick for Kentucky. I feel like this is a great move by EJ. They also got Nick Richards, by the way, yesterday. I saw that come in. Nick Richards is going to be in his third year. I expect great things from Nick. Nick's always been a great shot blocker, always good at catching lobs, throwing them down. If Nick could just develop a little more defense, like some foot movement, just be a little quicker on the offensive set and defensive set, stay with his guys, I feel like Nick Richards can have a great junior year. But basically, this is huge that EJ's returning because I was getting really, really worried. I didn't think EJ was going to return, and I thought that could have put Kentucky in a bad situation because EJ is a huge part of Kentucky's team this year. Without EJ Montgomery, you're looking at, all right, Nate Sestina, 23-year-old grad transfer from Bucknell, and Nick Richards. You only got two bigs, and those two might not be able to win you a championship by yourself. You got to have some type of bigs. Now, we are loaded in guards, loaded. Can't do much. So I'm really happy EJ returned. This is massive. Now we're just waiting on news on Kerry Blackshear. But see where if he's going to go pro. And if he doesn't, maybe Kentucky could try to push him to come here. But also, I'm going to say this name completely wrong. But there's a five-star kid who's my age. He's a junior in high school. Or he's going to go into a senior year next year. Niafoka Dante. He's a five-star center. Kentucky's trying to push him to reclassify. So we're going to see if they try to do that still. But now that we got EJ back. But it's good to see EJ back. I feel like this could turn in Kentucky from a contender or to like a team that possibly could win a championship. Now with EJ coming back, I think this team is a real championship contender. So that's huge for Kentucky. Also in 2020 and 2021, Calipari and Kentucky announced we could be having some games in London, England. So big things to look out there. That is awesome. Super happy EJ's returning. Short and simple, short video. Let's go, EJ. Good job, Nick, on the returning. I'm excited for next year. Let's go. Hope you like this video, Mac on Sports. Like, subscribe. You're getting a little doubleheader today. And on to the Bruins.